web cycle. Jump on it, jump on it, jump on it. The electron, transpertain, jump on it, jump on it. Carbohydrate, metabolism, jump on it, jump on it. First, you start off with glycolysis, and that begins by phosphorylation, which cleaves the sugar into two different three-carbon pieces. Then next comes the oxidation of those two separate three-carbon pieces, and in the end, it will form pyruvate two and ATP's four. Glycolysis. Jump on it. Jump on it. Jump on it. Krebs cycle. Jump on it. Jump on it. Jump on it. The electron. Transpertain. Jump on it. Jump on it. Carbohydrate. Metabolism. Jump on it. Now, upon entering the Krebs cycle, you must have the presence of pyruvic acid. The presence of pyruvic acid grants access to the Krebs cycle. Decarboxylation of pyruvic acid leads to the release of CO2. Oxidation occurs, acetic acid is formed and combined with coenzyme A, leading to the formation of acetyl-CoA. Now there are two pyruvic acids, and the products of each are CO2-3, ATP1, and reduced coenzyme 5. In the end, Krebs cycle products are a bunch of electrons and 4 ATPs.
Super is what I'll say.
Glycolysis. Jump on it. Jump on it. Jump on it. The Krebs cycle. Jump on it. Jump on it. Jump on it. The electron. Transpertain. Jump on it. Jump on it. Carbohydrate. Metabolism.
Jump on it.
ETC just rocket out on the crazy of mitochondrion along large energy levels of electrons are passed with what? Respiratory enzyme complexes. The electrons are passed along energy levels still given to oxygen, and then the H2O is formed. Electron energy carries the protons into the space of the inner membrane, and that's just how the synthase goes from the ATPs from electric flows. And ending carb metabolism, some products you need to know, go slam, dunk, know them all. 36 or 38 ATPs, 6 H2Os, and 6 CO2s. Glycolysis. Jump on it. Jump on it. Jump on it. The Krebs cycle. Jump on it. Jump on it. Jump on it. The electron, transpertain, jump on it, jump on it. Carbohydrate, metabolism,